So the newest tool in Photoshop is the selection brush, but is it necessary? In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use it and suggested use cases. I'm also going to show you Quickmask and where that might be a better fit. So let's jump in right now. All right, so let's have a look, first of all, how the selection brush works. So if we go to the brush here, we can choose the selection brush. Now it works like any selection tool, with the exception, we paint with this. So if I wanted to select this area, we paint and we can see the brush strokes. And in order to turn that into a selection, all we do is just choose another tool. Okay, so we've got a selection, and maybe we could have made this selection with the lasso tool. But the difference is, this has a soft edge. And in fact, we know that because if we go back to our selection tool, see we've got that soft edge, which you can only do using this or the quick mask, which we'll talk about in a second. Okay, so that's one advantage. All right, let's look at the settings on here. We can add to our selection just by simply painting. And as we paint, we keep adding to that selection. If we want to take away from the selection, we just change it to subtract. And now we can paint away, or we can refine that selected area. So some people like to do paint on selections and it works well for them. Let's go back to the add option. And if you want to subtract, an easy way to do that is with a keyboard shortcut. Hold down the Alt or the Option key. Now we're subtracting. Release, and now we're adding, and you can see how it toggles up here. The Alt or Option key will toggle it. So we've got two more. There's opacity, which we'll look at it in a second, and then there's the brush settings. We've got two settings, size and hardness. If you want it to work like regular selection tools, such as the lasso tool example, we turn the hardness all the way up. And now when we paint, we get a hard-edged selection. Now, in order to go to selection, I'm going to use a keyboard shortcut. I'm going to use the V for the move tool. We could be anyone, but we're going to choose V. Notice we get a selection. Now, if we want to go back to that brush, we hit the L key. Now we have a paintable selection. Hit the V key. This works very much like Quick Mask, where we'll be toggling the Q key. So let's go back and look at the settings. So if we want to change the brush size, we can do that with the left bracket key, or make it smaller, right bracket key, or make it bigger. We can also change the hardness using a keyboard shortcut. Watch up here, that shows a hard edge. If I held the shift key and I hit the left bracket key, notice it becomes softer. Right bracket key with the shift makes it harder. So we can add or we can take away for a selection while we're painting, but we can also use other tools. Now remember, when you choose another tool, it goes from the paint strokes to a selection or the marching ants. So we can add or take away. If I hit the shift key, we can add to that selection. Or if we hit the Alt key or the Option key, I can take away from that selection. And then of course, when we hit that L key, notice that that brush strokes have now been modified. There's other tools we can use. We can use the object selection tool if we wanted. So if I wanted to perhaps add her, I could hold down the shift key, click around there, and notice that she has now been added. If we hit that L key, you can see that. All right, so let's use this for practical purpose so you can see what it can do, and then we'll look at the quick mask. So one of the areas that does work well is when we're working with generative fill. So say we want to get rid of this girder. So why don't we grab the selection brush? We're going to make sure we've got a hard edge selection, and then we're going to go a little bit larger than here. So let's just click. Now release, hold the shift key and click again, and that'll draw a straight line, just like any of the brush tools. And let's do the same. We'll make it a little bit smaller. Left bracket key, click, hold shift, click again. Let's just keep doing it. Click, shift, click. All right, looks like there's a couple of little areas that we want to go over. So let's just paint over these. And maybe we don't want the arm included, so let's make it a little bit smaller. Left bracket key, hold down that Alt or the Option key, and we're just going to paint in there just to remove some of her arm. It doesn't matter if it goes over a little bit, because generative fill works really well in this case. So we're just going to choose generative fill, leave it blank, and click generate to remove this obstacle. All right, and that's worked fairly well. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. We can look at the other variations. This is probably a better variation on the elbow. Okay, now the shadow is still there. We could remove it the same way if we wanted, but it could also be casting a shadow from somewhere else. That's fine. Okay, so in this situation, when we're just doing a basic removal and we're using 100% opacity with a hard edge, this brush works very well. But let's look at something else that we can do with the selection brush, and that's where we can do a partial selection. So what we're going to do this time is we're going to change our opacity to 20%. And now we're going to take that hardness all the way down so we get a soft edge brush. So one of the things I'm going to do is I'm going to change this color from magenta, because the magenta kind of is going to mix in with the skin tone, and let's go something that stands out more, like maybe a green. And now we want to paint over her. So let's start painting. Now don't release, just paint over her in one go, because if you release your mouse and you click again, that 20% is going to become 40% where it overlaps. So we're just painting over there. So we've got our selection over there. If it looks like maybe there's some areas we want to get rid of it, let's make it a little smaller. And for cleanup, let's go to 100%. And we're just going to kind of just clean up where I went a little heavy-handed. All right. And maybe we want to do some kind of an effect on here. And because we're painted with only a 20%, we can go under the generate fill and we can do something like oil painting. And then click generate. So this is using a lower density. If it had been 100%, this would not work. But when we drop it down to 20% density, this does work. Now I've done another tutorial on this. Check that out. I'll link it beneath. All right, so we just need to go here under the mask and kind of clean it up a little bit because the face is distorted. So we want to paint with black. Let's just grab a regular brush. Set the foreground color to black. And we're just going to paint around the face here just to kind of bring that back. Get some resemblance of a human being again. And of course, if you wanted to just kind of blend this with the original, you could actually just bring the opacity back a little bit. See that? So we can determine how much of that kind of effect we want. So maybe that's a bit more realistic. All right, so we've got a different scenario here where we're going to cut out around trees, which is something that people struggle with. But before we do that, let's go back and I'm just going to quickly talk about the quick mask, how that works. So the quick mask works very similar. What we do is we choose a brush. We determine if we want a hard or a soft edge. Now, one of the advantages in quick mask is that we have many different brushes that we can use. Another advantage is that we have all of these settings. We can use opacity, flow, we can use pen pressure. We have a lot more tools at our disposal. So if we want to do a more complicated kind of a mask, then the quick mask is a good way to go. So let's see how it works. So in order to invoke quick mask, what we do is we hit the Q key or we tap at the bottom. And now we see we're in quick mask mode. Now, if we paint with black, notice we get that brush stroke just like we did when we were using the selection brush. Now to turn that into a selection, we hit the Q key and now it toggles. And yes, we can combine it with other selection tools just like we did, except this time, instead of hitting the L key, we hit the Q key to go back into quick mask. So we can do everything that we can do with the selection brush, we can do with quick mask. So if quick mask can do the same thing and more, why do we even have a selection tool? Why did Adobe spend the resources on it? Personally, I wish those resources had been allocated somewhere else, but we have the selection brush now, so let's look at it. Number one, it's easier for new users to use. And number two, for those quick touch-ups with generative fill, it is faster. Let me demonstrate. So let's look at a simple distraction removal. So if we want to use a selection brush, it could be one click or we could hit the L key. And then we do one drag. So let's say there's two clicks and then we're going to hit generative fill. Okay, so what if we wanted to do the same thing with a quick mask? How's this going to work? We're going to do one click to choose the brush tool. There's one. Q for quick mask. So that's two. Let's make sure we're painting with black. So that's three clicks. Four to drag it across there. Q again. That's five now. And then we can do the generator fill. Okay. So the selection brush for a quick fix like that, uses half the amount of clicks we would need for the quick mask, and it's easier for a beginner. Okay, let's look at a situation where the quick mask is going to be a lot better. So we're going to choose the select menu, and then we're going to grab color range. So with color range, what we do is we choose a color, we click, then we're going to grab the plus tool to add to that selection and click around those other areas. So let's just tap, and as you can see, we're getting pretty close. Now we use the fuzziness to refine this selection. So what we're trying to do is get the best possible edge around there. And that's getting pretty close. Now, why didn't we use the select sky? I'll show you in a minute, but let's click OK. All right, so we've got this selection, but let's inverse the selection because we want to select everything but the sky. Command Shift I. So now we've selected everything else, but we need to add the mountains to this selection. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab the object selection, and to add, hold down the Shift key, and we're going to paint around here to add those mountains. All right, it's pretty good, but there's little gaps in here. See these little gaps? So now I could use the selection brush here when we go into selection, and let's not make it green when we're working on the trees. Let's go to something like a, let's go back to the magenta. And then we would paint in here and we could clean up these edges. See that? And we can add to it. Let's go for a hard edge. We can add these mountains, making sure we're selecting all these areas. All right. This is working pretty good. But the problem is there could be little holes in here and we can't see it. Okay, so let's just, you know, click on another tool here. And we can see, yeah, some marching ants in some areas. So it's kind of hard to know where those are. So here's the thing. I could grab this brush right now and I could go back to the selection brush, or I could use the more superior tool, which is a quick mask. If I hit the Q key, this is going to do the same thing, but it's going to convert it. Now with the quick mask, there's a couple of things. One, if I double click, we can change the color of the overlay. The other thing which I wish we could do in the selection brush is I can change the opacity really high. So let's hit the Q again, and now you can clearly see the areas that have been selected that shouldn't be. And if we grab a brush, paint with black, we can add to this. If we invert this, hit the X and paint with white, we can paint out those areas. See that? Now there's another hidden thing that we have with the quick mask that we can't do with the selection brush on this more complicated selection. If we go to the channels, notice what happens. When I hit the Q key, it goes to a selection. Then I hit Q key again and it shows quick mask. It's creating a temporary alpha channel. So an alpha channel is how Photoshop works with selections. So what we're going to do is we're going to turn off RGB, and now we see a mask, a clear mask. And so if I paint with white, look at this, I can clean up these areas here. I can very easily clean up those areas painting with white, and I can see them. If I paint with black, I can see these areas, and I can also work with those. The other thing while we're working inside the quick mask is we can use other selections with the quick mask, and I could do this and fill it with black, which would very quickly help us to clean this up. Now the other thing we can do for these areas that are gray, here's another trick for you. We can use levels with the quick mask. Control L will bring up levels. And if we see these areas here, we can clean those up just by dragging. Look at that. See how we can quickly just clean up those areas? Let me just clean this up a little bit here manually. And if we want to turn this back, you just hit the Q key once again, and this goes back to a selection. So let's mask this and see what kind of a mask we've got here. So if we create a mask here, we can see that, like maybe let's create a solid color, put it behind it. All right, so if we look at this, it's not perfect, but it's not too bad and it can be cleaned up. Let me compare this really quickly to the sky selection. So I'm gonna hide this, we're gonna get rid of this mask. And let's do select sky. All right, let's create our inverted mask. Hold down the Alt or the Option key, create a mask. Okay, so look at this. This is the sky selection, quick mask. Now they all need a little bit of refinement, but this is certainly getting us a lot closer. When you're doing a very, very quick selection, use the selection tool. But when you need a more robust tool set, use the Quickmask. So I'm curious, what are your thoughts? Do you think the selection brush is necessary, or is it a waste of development times? Would you use it? Do you find use cases for it? Let me know in the comments underneath. And if you want to know how to easily convert your photos to art using generative AI, check out this tutorial here. And if you're new to the cafe, welcome. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.